could be I know that there are stations there that you can view like dash cam footage and whatnot. I don't know if you can see through the window.
Okay.
There's also another like meeting table over there. I don't know if they have another intended purpose for that room, but it does get used pretty frequently for meetings and whatnot.
Okay.
Yeah,
It's
also,
nice.
Shania, sometimes she'll be at that first window all the way to the right. That's where people who return from Bolingbrook who need to retrieve their items can go and speak to her there. She
Right,
yeah,
okay.
she can yeah, she can be kind of like Grant over there. She can be a little standoffish, but honestly, she's very sweet. She really if you give her enough time, she'll open up about her nieces and nephews and it's off to the races.
Yeah, fair enough. You know, it's nice, nice bit of conversation.
Yeah,
All right.
exactly.
Has anyone got a dash cam on right now?
Oh, that's a great question. I gotta start bugging people. Let's see. Ugh, suffering.
Don't worry. If I
No.
get hired, I will make sure. I'm gonna make it mandatory.
Oh, yes, please.
Yeah, I got
Because for
some
the first couple
ideas.
of weeks, for the first couple of weeks, people were on their dash cams and I was like, wow, this is so fascinating. And for the past, I don't know, a couple of weeks, no dash cams. Sad. But that's okay.
We'll get
I
it fixed.
understand
Don't
that
worry.
they've got plenty of other things to worry about outside of dash cam stuff and all of that.
No. It's very important. It's very important. I got listen, chat. If between me and you, I got some big ideas. Okay.
Oh, okay.
I'm thinking CCTV for
Oh,
dispatch. Like around. I'm thinking
that would
like.
be so helpful for you all. Oh my gosh.
Exactly, you know. I'm thinking like, like emergency alerts that like pop up on your phone. Like a dispatcher could
Yeah.
do that if we have like a suspect at large, so we can get 911 calls in.
Oh,
Yeah,
wait.
we can
Ooh.
even like send. We could do one if we have like a photograph of the suspect. We could like send it to everybody's phone, and everybody gets like
Oh,
a photograph, and he's like wanted
wait.
for assault on a police officer. Be careful if you see this
Yeah.
man, call 911. You know what I mean?
Wait, I love that. Yeah, no,
Yeah.
that's a great way to sort of like you said, public service announcement. That is so smart.
Yeah. I've been cooking. I've been cooking. Okay. You don't have to have. I want to speak to Kiki Pendragon. Do you have her number?
Kiki Pendragon, the name is familiar. Let me
Head
see
of
here.
EMS.
Oh, okay. I don't think I do, but I'm gonna double check nonetheless. I unfortunately do not. I'm trying to think of who I have contact-wise who might have her number. Let's see.
You check the is it on her profile?
Oh wait! Oh my gosh, Dadoy. Okay, yeah, let me see here.
Don't forget you got some good access to some good tools, Chastity.
I do. I kind of remember that. I'll see. Phone number. I actually do not. Let me see here. I'll try this.
Do you know because where it pecks out? I don't know any of these people, so I'm just gonna put them all on the shift one.
She actually does not have her phone number listed on her profile.
Okay. I got a question for you then. I'm gonna teach you
Yeah.
something. I don't know whether you know this. Are you allowed to run plates?
I don't know how to do that.
Okay.
So odds are I may or may it's Schro it, this is Schrodinger's question because I didn't know that was a thing. Well, I assume for officers it very likely is, and I imagine for dispatch it's probably a very useful tool, but that is not something I've encountered at all.
Okay, I don't know whether you Okay, I won't push you to check then, just in case. All right, I'll give Flop a call. I'm sure Flop has it.
Okay.
But I'll be around for a little bit. I might come chat in a bit. But thank you, Chastity. I appreciate the
absolutely
transparency. You know, I'll catch you in a bit. Okay.
Of course. All right. Thank you so much. Bye.
Fucking hung up on me, Chastity. Cassidy's great, dude. What a good person to have in that reception, dude. Like, Jesus. I'm assuming these are shift one, but I don't know for sure. You could edit this a little. Minus one, editing text written in pen. Oh, sweet, you know, diabetes. I need a snack.
Also, oh my gosh, I just realized I don't have your phone number because I found her phone number.
Wait, what?
Yeah, okay, so I found her phone number and I just realized I don't have your phone number, so I was about to try to look up your phone number so that I could give you her phone number.
Oh, how did you find it?
It was literally me not knowing how to read, so it was under the staff profile.
Okay.
And my eyes completely glazed over it.
It happens to us all, don't worry. Mm-hmm. Okay, what's your number?
I appreciate that. All right, so of course the obligatory 420.
Yeah.
And then 209-4214.
Okay, thank you. And my number is 420-817-8147.
Brilliant. Thank you so much.
All right, thanks, Jess. Give me a text. I got yours still.
All right, you got it.
I have some shit in my bag.
What? Gotta grind. What a grind. Oh, I do have a number. Oh, news. You know, a bit of prison. Come on, then. If Kiki's around, I doubt she is, but I kind of want to hear from EMS. Sorry. I want to know what EMS would think about their own radio channel. Maybe I'm jumping ahead a little bit. I don't know. I feel like EMS have always been fucked over, you know? But, like, obviously, in a perfect world, EMS have their own radio channel with fire, and they have their own dispatcher, and then all that happens is someone, like, you know, you just got a PD dispatcher in a room, you got an EMS dispatcher in a room, PD requests 52 to the dispatcher, the dispatcher shouts to the other dispatcher, say, hey, we got a 52 request on, I don't know, Vespucci and Elgin. And then that dispatcher gets a fucking EMS over there, you know what I mean? I think it would be cool. I don't think there's any other dispatchers around right now. Flop seems busy because he hung up. Probably gonna get some food. Oh, what am I doing at a red light? I hope the wait doesn't take too long. I hope it's a quick thing. Because I'm sick and tired of waiting. I just want to get going, dude. Make sure me know. Get rid of all of this. Let's do an ideas and improvement. How long has it been since the first interview? That's a good question that I do not know the answer to. It was with Hayes and Leah, and it was off stream. Was it off stream? Did I do it off stream? I can't remember. I think I did it off stream. See, I think I did it off stream because I didn't think it would be like a big deal. Because I thought it was just going to be like, oh, here's an interview. Let's get you sorted and hired. Do you know what I mean? Like, I didn't think it was going to be... It's not like a... Okay, this isn't like an ego thing. It was just like, Dark's got experience. It probably was... It was... It was the 25th of January, yeah? Oh my god. I did not realize... We've basically been on a fucking hot touch.
Say.
Sorry, I'll do...
Can we go talk about the door?
Alright. Please.
It's fucking... Oh my god, can you do your job?
One 118's up.
Oh, I'm sorry, can you please do it again?
Do not swipe. What? Is everyone okay? Like, are you been taking drugs or something? Like, what's been happening?
You guys want to do the artists own their shit, right? That you share that sentiment?
Cool.
She'll be over here, right?
Well, yeah, I've got to redo the order because, you know, it took a long time to swipe your card. There you go, swipe your card. Now. Your order number will be 119.
Sometimes I lose it, you know?
Just tap your card on the machine.
There we go. Thank you.
You alright?
Hey! Sorry,
hello, can I just get
I like your mustache.
I'm married.
It's fine, I'm a lesbian. It's fine, I'm just complimenting you. Sorry, I guess I can't compliment somebody.
Can I just get a combo, please? I'll just get a cheeseburger, No onions on that, please. With a sprunk with extra ice.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Sprunk with extra ice, okay.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Alright.
There you go, if you want to swipe your card, your number will be 120.
Thank you.
119.
Cheers.
Hope you enjoy that sprunk with no ice.
Wow.
Oh my god, well, there's
an asshole. How long should be in the married thing broken? Ooh. You're broken.
Oh no, shit. Never mind. Because he said he was
busy sweating.
Oh, 120.
Thanks, Mike.
Yeah, there we go.
Okay, then come to send your box.
What the hell is this burger?
Bro, quit complaining. Eat that shit, bro.
There's nothing on it. It's just meat.
What you get. That's what you get.
You guys gotta learn how to do your job, okay?
You just take a compliment and not, you know, just don't think I'm trying to hit on you.
Listen, everybody tries to hit on me. You just say that I'm married, okay?
He's trying to get some.
I
Come
hate
on, bro.
Gingers.
What the hell?
Fucking hate
really?
You guys.
Really? Okay. All right. She's the one with dyed hair. I bet you were ginger originally, weren't you?
I'm a brunette, actually.
Oh, right.
I'm
but you're just afraid.
You're
at least I'm not afraid of my own hair color, you know?
The best.
Okay. All right. Listen, you guys working half hours.
Enjoy your playing a burger and just sprunk with no ice.
I'm going to complain. I'm going to leave a review with.
Do it, pussy.
The fuck, dude? Someone just tweeted, there's a dick sucking competition at Senior Buns. Is that true gold? Ginger people can go to the cinema for free in heat waves? What the fuck? Is it really?
You slut, huh?
Sock Blue. 22H, morning sock 22, hey?
They were the 15 months, I appreciate it. Thank you. I fucking set this fucking speed, you bitch. There's a ginger day. Who knew? You know what we can do? I've got an idea. I've got a good idea. You know, it would be a fun little bit RP, yeah. Let's go down to Mission Row and we'll stand outside. And as carts come in and out, we can stop them for a short survey on dispatch and what they would like and what they think is needed. We could be like one of those people on the high street that stop you for a survey about trees, you know? You're a cop. I need a stop sign. Perfect. Look at Rich. He's got the sun between his legs. Anyway, let's wait for an interview. I don't think there's a lollipop man emote. No, there is stop signs, but I don't know how you get them. Why did they get rid of the booth? I was just thinking about it. Don't get me wrong, it looks kind of... This looks clean, but... The PD booth was kind of fun, you know? Hello?
Hey, Richard.
Anyone care for a short survey about dispatch in shift 3? Yeah.
Hi, let's do it.
Okay, thank you. I'll catch up with the others. I'll catch up with you guys later, okay? I'll give you five bucks, all right? $5 an interview.
I don't need $5. I'll definitely do anything you need, Richard.
Thanks, Alice. Yeah.
And I'm like, Corwood, we don't know if you interfered. Get back on the call. It's okay. It's all right.
Yeah.
Is that why you hung up on me?
I have been so fucking busy today. I wish I could be.
Oh, it's been good though. It's been a good ass day.
It has been good. It's been great.
Mm-hmm.
Want some fries?
No, I'm okay. All right, let's go talk. Alice, I'll catch up with you soon.
Yeah, just give me a ring whenever you're ready.
So, how are you?
Overwhelmed. Overworked.
Oh, dear.
Auditors came back.
I came back? What do you mean came back?
Oh, they had input for me.
For you?
Yeah.
Well, what do you mean?
Here, come here. I'll tell you. It said, and I quote, Flop needs to do more work.
What? Why? I've been doing work.
It's bolder than to... So apparently my reports got audited. Willie.
Wait, why
Willie,
you?
Do you remember Willie? Willie was one of two people I talked to. He told me he audited my reports, and I'm like, you know...
Okay, fuck Willie. All right.
1:25:10:07.
You don't gonna worry about Willie.
Listen, he's like, why don't you have a lot of reports? And I said, I'll tell you. And I explained Tim Turner was, you know, LOA, and I stepped up as, you know, essentially, you know, for lack of a better term, an acting captain. Went through the whole process, and apparently, at the mayor's office, everybody was saying that my name was Frolicking Flop because all I do is go up into the mountains and look at rabbits.
Pretty funny though.
Oh, my dispatch card says 125 Dugong, Flop Dugong. Side note, frolicking right now.
That's what it says right now?
Damn fucking right, that's what it says. I make a note that I'm fucking frolicking. I'll embrace that shit. Laziest cop, that's me.
I gotta put that, make a note.
Yeah, make a note. Listen, they gonna say I'm lazy? You best believe I'm gonna fucking embrace it.
Yeah, let's not be it. We don't need to. Listen, we don't need to get into the shit talking, okay? But Willie, you know.
Oh, Willie's, no, I'm going to get into the shit talking.
Willie's
I'm going
to
be,
you know.
I'm going to be fucking blunt. Nah, I'm going to be blunt with you, okay? I'm going to shit talk Willie. And the reason why I'm going to shit talk Willie is because I gave him a full explanation as to why my reports were not, you know, fully through. And I've been told that I don't do enough reports, which tells me one thing. The auditor's job is to listen to me and provide feedback, right? The auditor failed to audit and became selective in how they wanted to do their information, which means the auditors did not listen to me, which means they're making a false assumption, which means I have no reason to trust them if they can't seem to take my word for anything.
I mean, we're saying them. Is it just Willie or was it others?
It was Malton. And Malton's like, you should really talk to Willie. Oh my God, you should talk to Willie. He's got some stuff to tell you. Ooh-hoo-hoo. So I saw Willie and he's like, so I audited your reports. So I only talked to two auditors. But yeah.
Yeah, it's like he's holding grudges. Listen, all I'm saying is...
He is holding...
Until they brought Willie's name up, I forgot who that guy was. He was just that unimportant. So the fact that you've lived rent-free in that guy's bald head for the past for five years is embarrassing.
Yeah, well, I mean, the other reality, too, is I told Barrick, I said, do you want my honest input on the audit team? He goes, what's that? I said, that's what I think.
The hell about Jenny?
Well, I'm sure Jenny's great.
Yeah. Like, well, I mean, when did their audits finish?
I don't know.
Like, was their audits for what got Barrick chief of police? You know what I mean? Like, what?
No, the audits were just to see what's going on internally in the PD, formulate an opinion, and sort of provide information. And apparently the auditors failed to do that. And that was their takeaway.
Yeah, but that was that one takeaway about you. You don't know that that's all that they did, yeah.
I was catching strays, Dad. I was catching fucking strays. Just ignore
it. Just ignore it, okay?
Oh, no. I am going to ignore it. I'm going to do more work like they want me to. I feel bad for every motherfucker in traffic with me who makes it right without using their signal. That's all I'm saying.
Okay. All right. Fair enough. Anyway, it's not why we're here. I spoke to Barrett this morning. First of all, I still haven't heard. Come on.
Hey, what's up, Sherry?
Oh, fuck, Sherry. Hang up.
I'm a little backed up right now, a little busy. Can this wait?
Yes, it can.
What do you mean, no? Okay, if this is not urgent, I'm gonna hang up, but go ahead. All right, bye-bye.
What was it?
Okay. You said yes is important. I said if it's not important, halfway through, I'm hanging up. Nope. This is my fucking life, Dad. What, you're seeing it right here live.
Yeah, it's pretty bad, huh?
It's fucking terrible.
Okay. So, I spoke to Barrick. Well, I haven't heard from Tona still. And I don't know how many hours it's been. It's 100 plus hours. It's a lot of hours.
He has not been around in like 4 days. I don't know what's going on with him, but I have not. I need to interrogate him over something, and I haven't been able to see him. So.
Okay. Well, yeah. But then I spoke to Barrick, and he says, regardless of the outcome of Turner's interview, you're getting hired. So that's good news, you know. He wants me to help run things. I don't know whether I can't remember specifically, but I don't know whether he wants me to help run shift 3 specifically or like the whole thing. I don't know.
Tell me what he told you, and I'm going to fill in gaps because I have information.
He just said he wants me to like help lead things. I think I'm not very good at remembering specifics on the call. There was a lot.
I'm going to tell you what Barrick said off the record.
Yeah.
Keep this to yourself.
Wait.
This man looked at me, I told me over the phone, because he told me that he was, you know, pretty much that you were, put simply, in, for the most part. And I told him that it was the best choice he could have made. And he said himself, out of every candidate we've had, not only has all of Dispatch wanted him, but he's the only one who is as passionate about this department over every other applicant that we've had. And waiting on it is doing nothing. He's passionate for you.
Yeah, I think so. So I figured he said he's going to, I mean, he said the chief of police has to talk to him about getting me hired. It's a bit concerning, but.
It's really not that concerning. And I'll tell you why. Per our chain of command, guess who the final say is? You guessed it, Barrick.
Right, so why would he have to do it in the first place? No, he's saying that it's the same process that I had, which is not a good process. Anyway, let's get past that, okay? I trust him.
you have a lot of trust in Barrick, and I'm telling you now that you are going to be... You're in.
All right, if that's the case, then I'm going to get started before I'm hired. So that's what I want to talk to you about is what do you think dispatch? I guess there's a couple of things. What do you want to see from dispatch? And you, what do you think dispatch needs from your point of view as an officer?
I think dispatch.
Let me get to, hold on. Let me get you my notes.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, hold on. Here we go. Okay, what, first of all, what do you want to see?
I want to see dispatch sort of just. I don't want to see dispatch as dispatch. I want to see them as a. I don't want dispatch as a separate entity. I want you guys to be a part of us, right? I want you guys to intermingle essentially with what we do, and help adapt and keep us on course. I want to see a lot of the tools that we have that are to the value of dispatch to start being utilized, like dash cams, as you guys can be witnesses in court if something were to happen and you witness it on the camera. Shit like that, I think, is so valuable and so important. I think the establishment of something more consistent in Shift 3 is a no-brainer. I think that's already kind of, that goes without saying, but we currently have a very spotty, you know, group going on right now. Not that anyone's bad, it's just, it's kind of hit or miss, you know what I mean? Some consistency is nice. Not that I expect everyone to be around all the time, though, so.
Okay, so that's what you want to see, but like, what do you think dispatch needs? So this might be even from your own personal kind of use of the system and the radio. What,
like,
do you think?
Like future integrations for like future tools for you, or like
it could be tools like that. It could be like an IT thing. It could be a.
I think it would be really cool for you to, for example, hey, you know. How many units are on the laundromat robbery call? Okay, we have 125, 116, 160, 124. Okay. Putting us on a card and being able to move us all over to a frequency at once would be fucking sweet. That would be kind of cool. I don't know how that would be integrated. That might be a lot to ask for, but you having the control to help out with that, I think would be huge.
That would be pretty nice. Yeah, I agree. Right? Anything else?
I really haven't given this thought. You have a lot more of a vision. What are some of your ideas? Because maybe I'll be inspired to kind of give you suggestions.
I mean, okay,
I haven't really given a thought.
I won't give you any specifics, but like, it doesn't have to be like an IT thing. It can be like a. It can even just be like a. You know, whether or not like dispatch should be someone who can tell a cop to go to a call. Do you think that should be a thing? Know what I mean? Like, like what the level of dispatching do you want to see? Do you want it to be like
priority? Just... Priority would be kind of interesting.
What do you mean by that?
The prioritization of calls. If shots fired are happening at the hospital, you know, maybe a traffic stop is not the most important thing. Hey, how many units are on that traffic stop? Okay. You know, I mean, obviously, seniors delegate a lot of that. We take part in making sure that, you know, people are organized. But I don't think it hurts to see dispatch be respected and to kind of have a little bit of authority of organization, right? Because your job's to organize this to some degree.
Yeah. So, yeah, okay. So, yeah, do you think dispatch should have... What level of authority do you think dispatch should have?
Level of authority? That's a really hard one. Because
I think, listen, I don't think it's up to you or me. I think that's going to be up to like Beric and the captains at the end of the day. But
it's either
going to
be
like...
Beric and the captains, or I'm going to be blunt with you. I hate this system. I hate this method. But shit, I mean, I think just doing it, right? Maybe start off with a little bit of authority, seeing how things are, welfare checks, get units to check on other units, stuff like that. If that starts pushing a line. Yeah, but if it starts pushing a line, okay, maybe we dial it back a little bit.
Yeah, I agree with you. I think it's more the fact that if we do it that way, if we set out some standards from the start, then the problems that are going to arise are going to be more, like, manageable versus, like, just coming out of nowhere. Like, I think having standards from the start... will stop someone like me, who's more authoritative, having like the problems, and then someone who's not very authoritative not having problems, where if everyone does it the same way, then we can manage the problems across the board. You know what I'm saying?
I get that. I mean, so then do it the other way. Start lower, start slower, and then, you know, come to one of the meetings one day if you're able to, and just stand in front of the room and say, hey, you know, it's me, your dispatch lead, or, you know, whatever your title is. And ask people, like, hey, how are we feeling? Dispatch is going so far. Do we like where it's at? Do we have any suggestions? We can even talk with the captains and or Barrick.
Oh, fuck, I'm stuck.
About getting a form, maybe a month into dispatch, and getting people to put in just their anonymous interest on how dispatch can improve their shift, and start incorporating some of that, right?
Cool. I mean, yeah, I'd hope that. But it's just intimidating enough that it needs to be anonymous. I hope they can just come talk to us. Okay, so
it doesn't have to be anonymous. I'm just throwing out suggestions.
I mean, I've had some ideas about some dispatches, but I want you to keep it between me and you, okay? Yeah, because I wanna listen, bring. Watch it.
I'm a senior for a reason. Unfortunately, half my job is keeping things to myself and knowing what I can say and what I can't say. So,
listen, my idea is, here's my idea. I want this. So this is why I think about it. I enjoy dispatch and the way it is, right? But not a lot of people do. Just doing the radio. Some people, for a lot of people sitting in a room doing the radio is boring, right? But we want, there's two things we want here. I think the Barrick and the captains don't want dispatch to be a stepping stone for PD. So that means we need dispatchers who want to be dispatchers and stay around and be dispatchers. And for a lot of people, sitting in a room and just staring at the wall and listening to the radio is not very interesting. You know, as much as I disagree, I think that's just a fact. So I was thinking, I think we need to get more visual up in this home dog, this bitch. So I think...
Stop.
Watch it. What the kids say,
don't ever, ever say that again.
Okay. Anyway, so I've got a few things I want to suggest. First of all, is having dash cams, but not having them. I don't know how they work right now, but essentially what I want to happen is if you pull up your dispatch system and you have the map open, I want the ability to be able to like pull up somebody's dash cam and keep it on the map. So like you can like move the map around, but your dispatch cam is still like in the corner, so you can see that cam at all times. So hypothetically, you could have every dash cam of every officer on duty open on the screen at once, right? It wouldn't be very practical, but
we're gonna walk and talk, because I feel like this is more worthy in the dispatch room.
Okay, all right.
Oh. You hungry?
Nah, I've just eaten.
Okay.
Eaten.
Mm. Eaten. Mm. Mm. Yeah. Mm. Jesus.
Room so beautiful. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh yeah. Okay. Listen, this is my idea for now. It might change. My goal for now is PD dispatcher. PD dispatcher. EMS dispatcher, the possibility of having EMS on a different channel so that they can do their own things and, you know, have their own, so they don't get stuck on 301 anymore. 911 operator and, I don't know, a spare chair, I guess. And then someone
trainee,
like me.
Maybe?
Maybe, yeah, like a trainee or something. So, these are my ideas. So, you could have, like, you know, for example, with these screens, you could.
I'm gonna shit. I need people to just fuck off for a couple minutes. I'm sorry.
Okay. You.
Oop, that's not what I wanted. Sorry.
You taking a selfie right now?
No. I clicked the wrong app. I was just looking at my contacts, so I knew who's calling me.
Listen, I try and keep it short and sweet. I want dispatch to be more visual, right? So having the ability to keep an eye on dash cams during, let's say there's like a traffic stop going on and one location, traffic stop at another location. You can have both dash cams open at the same time while
I'm
also
check something real quick.
I imagine if you look at a dash cam right now, you'd get sucked in and it would be a full screen. You wouldn't be able to see nothing else.
Yep.
Yeah.
Tell you what though, I could still hear you, which is good.
That's
good.
I'm curious
about this. Hold on. I'm curious about the other thing.
The other thing.
Security cameras.
What, there is security cameras?
Apparently, but it's
okay,
it's
that's part of my plan. Okay, so step one, dash cams. Ability to have multiple open at the same time. You know, if you open your GPS, you could have, like, you know, as many dash cams as you want to keep an eye on the safety of officers, right? Then this is gonna be the controversial one. Body cams. But not recorded. The only intention is for officer safety, right? It's to keep an eye on body cams so that you can know that they're an officer. So, for example, let me give you an example. Let's say you are in a foot pursuit, but you're on your own.
Do you see my little camera there on my left shoulder?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I mean,
yeah, I mean, yeah. So let's say you're in a foot pursuit, but you're on your own. You got two suspects in front of you. You know, you're busy trying to control that scene. What dispatch could do instead is dispatch could take over comms for you right there because they can see through your body cam. And then obviously you're so busy trying to handle two suspects who might be armed that you can't keep up comms or whatever. So I can keep comms for you while that's happening. And then I can, let's say they start shooting you or whatever. You get shot down. I was watching so I can see the suspect who shot you. And I can give a description on the radio and where they are, right?
I think if it would be interesting to see if we could buy like batteries or something that we could install and sort of I like not have it be a requirement, but give people the option because I would approve that. I would love that.
Now, this is the thing. I understand that the objection to body cams has always been if it gets used in court, you know, then there wouldn't be a lot of objection to be made. But I'm not looking for that reason. I'm just looking for dispatch to be more of a visual and more useful tool for PD.
You want
to
help be our eyes and ears from behind the desk.
Basically, TLDR, I want dispatch to go from more from just being the person on the radio to being Big Brother. You know, I want to be overwatching the PD, which comes to my next part, security cams. Whether it be inside Senior Buns or inside the laundromat to intersections having traffic cams that we can keep an eye on. Let's say there's a pursuit, you've lost a vehicle. I can call out in here to the dispatchers to go on the traffic cams in a one, you know, in a radius around that location. And we can see if we can spot the vehicle on the traffic cam. You know what I mean? It's just a little bit extra that dispatch can do that can be super useful. And that can scale with the budget. But obviously, you know, if we get security cams around the city, what about if people hack them? That could be real dangerous, you know? Now, maybe it's a dangerous idea to bring up, but it could be...
Nah, maybe.
It could be pretty interesting. And then the last one is another suggestion I thought of, is giving dispatchers the ability to make, not Amber Alerts, but the equivalent of, like, an alert that goes to everybody's phone in the city. So let's say you've just been shot down by Mr. K, but we don't know it's Mr. K. Let's say it's just a guy wearing, I don't know, an orange jumpsuit and a white dance hat. Okay, dispatch can then send an alert to the whole city saying, armed and dangerous man, if you see a man wearing orange jumpsuit and a white dance cap, call 911 immediately, right? And then everyone in the city then knows, oh shit, something's just popped off, you know what I mean? Because most of the time, something happens, like something big happens like that, people don't know about it. They might hear about it in the hospital or something. But then this might give us, like, 911 calls might come in then from people, like concerned citizens who spot them at a clothing store. We might get a 911 call coming in. Do you see where I'm going here?
No, I see where you're going. You guys would have so much, we'll call it, power to help oversee.
Exactly.
And I think that is something that we could use and something that we need. That's huge.
Yeah. So I think it would also move dispatch into being a more enjoyable position for people. Don't get me wrong, I also want to like sort out, I also want like an office environment that makes just being in the room with each other enjoyable too, you know?
Well, actually, yeah, no, definitely. Here, come here for a second. I'm curious. I mean, this is an unoccupied room. I mean, there is always the opportunity. Actually, it would be beside the armory, but this would be an interesting spot to see if like we can get you guys like a little. Yeah, yeah. I was going to say like a break room or like a just a dispatch briefing office room for you guys.
Yeah, yeah. That'd be great.
Dispatch briefing?
Yeah. Like every shift, we have a little briefing about stuff that's going on. We can have meetings with dispatchers from cops and being like, hey, we got a bunch of these calls coming in. Can you keep us updated? Get people to those, get routed to those calls. You know what I mean?
I'm going to say something that might bite me in the ass, but I'm going to say it anyway. The reason why I think you were such a good pick for dispatch and the reason why I'm excited to see where you kind of head dispatch once it's official is that I want people to want dispatch. And because for forever, dispatch was like a stepping stone, right?
Exactly, yeah.
And I don't like that mentality. And even people nowadays have seen it with that mentality as some kind of grounds to say, hey, you know, I've been working with you guys for a while. But really, you're making dispatch desirable.
Yeah, that's the goal.
And I don't know how else to say that without it sounding like a little cheesy, but you are essentially fronting to try and make dispatch a desirable position.
Yeah.
Honestly, if you were to incorporate all that and I were to just say, for example, something were to happen with my occupation, damn, you bet your ass I would love to sit in this fucking room. Or even on my off time. Yeah. I would love that.
Listen, the way I'm going to do it is, if I get dispatched, I'm going to join, I'm going to work for a couple of days, talk to the captains, talk to Beric, get some feedback. But then I'm thinking about setting up like, because I can go and I can pitch those ideas, right? Probably to the mayor, whatever, to Beric. And they could be like, yeah, that sounds great. But it's probably not go anywhere. But I'm thinking, I'm going to go and I'm going to get some officers like you. I'm going to get Matt. I might get a few more officers. And we're going to set up on a different channel. And we're going to do like a, we're going to do some acting, okay? We're going to film a movie, all right? And we're going to have a bunch of dispatchers in here. And we're going to role play a situation out. And I'm gonna recreate it on a computer at home, and I'm gonna like basically like show off what my idea is for this, and like
I don't want to pretend.
You mean you don't want to pretend? No, it's just you mean
I don't want to pretend. What do you mean? I have to pretend I'm chasing somebody?
I mean. Not really. It's just not. I mean, kind of. I suppose. Yeah.
I have to like what pretend to that I'm chasing somebody, and I gotta like just play into it.
I mean, yeah. It's just you know, it's like acting. It's like acting, but there's no script. You can do that,
you
right?
You don't have a fucking script for this?
I mean, I can write one if you need one.
Oh,
that make it easier.
I don't know. I'm willing to help out. It sounds like a lot. Yeah. No, I'm.
You know,
I'm,
maybe you can just. You know, maybe I'll ask somebody else. Okay.
No,
it's fine. It's fine.
I'm willing to help out. It sounds interesting. Like it just. I guess I'm confused. I think to record something and sort of show an example as to what it could be would be really cool. I'll give you that.
Okay. Thanks. Yeah.
I approve of it. I mean, look at this. Look. Just gonna get a like, close up. I mean,
look at that. That's a traffic cam on the top right, I think. It's like a CCTV. Got a bunch of shit on it.
It's a security camera on Calais and Vespucci.
Yeah. I mean, that's exactly the kind of thing I'm talking about, you know? Like, imagine you lost a car down on Adam's Apple. And so we're like, okay, let's get on this camera and we can call out, hey, it's going northbound. You know what I mean? And the thing is, this would make, I mean, if this gets implemented, dispatch would be a fucking target because this would be dangerous in the wrong hands, you know, my hands. I will make the criminals' lives a living hell.
I think you want to know what's beautiful about dispatch, though, is you would be our eyes and ears, but you would also be in the most protected spot in this PD.
Yeah, but I've got to come to work and go home from work. Don't forget. Well, oh my God, I just had another idea. What about to save on manpower? What about if dispatch could control the camera for Air One? You know, like when Air One goes up in the sky?
Now, that would also mean Air One would have to do, or dispatch would have to do comms as well.
Oh yeah, maybe not then. Actually, no, you got a point. You got a point.
I don't disagree, but it would just be a matter now you have to train dispatchers to, you know, right?
I mean, dispatch should be good at bloody comms.
They should be. I mean, that's the goal. There's so much here though that I'm thinking about now. I'm strangely enough as inspired by your passion, because I think that this will be really cool.
Yeah, I hope so. I think I think Beric really wants to support this and get this up and running. So
I'm gonna be kind of quiet about it when I say this, but you practically already have the job.
I mean, that's what he's saying, but just the waiting part stresses me out.
I get it, and I can't stop you from feeling stressed out about that. Just know that there's a lot of passion in what you're looking at, and I don't think anyone sees it any other way. I think that you are going to be the front that people are going to be excited to see.
I hope so. Okay, so just to check, to get... So the feedback from you is I'm frolicking right now. You want to see dispatch part of PD?
No.
I'm writing that down. No, I want to see dispatch part of PD intermingle, help adapt and keep on course, use dash cams on all the tools because they're valuable and important. We could testify in court. Yeah, I agree with that. And you just want consistency from dispatch. It's not a problem. What do you think we need? Like moving all units on a call to a frequency at once and then prioritization of call. Okay, anything else you want to add there? I'm just doing some research, yeah.
The thing is, I really haven't given it a lot of like deep thought. It's weird. I've given so much a lot of thought. The reason I haven't given dispatch a lot of thought, like deep down, oh, thank you, I appreciate it, is because my goal has been getting dispatch fucking running.
Yeah.
And it's like, I like to think, it drives me up the fucking wall to think that you gotta crawl before you walk. And if we have no one crawling, then there's no chance of them being able to walk. And without you here or without dispatchers here, it's hard to it's hard to find time to find that those like passionate goals. But I think start small, work your way up, get a feel for people to know who you are. Maybe find time to come to the meeting, or I can try and schedule a little shift 3 meeting at some point, a little 10-minute meeting.
Time to meeting.
2 a.m. EST, so 4 hours from If you can't do that, I can make a call to get everyone down to, you know,
I might be able to schedule it. See what I can.
I would wait to talk with. It'll come to me. Talk with Beric. And just let him know that you want to get people's inputs on dispatch and that you're very passionate to hear ideas to understand how you're going to essentially incorporate dispatch into a new system.
I'll do that once I'm high. I don't want to, you know, step too far like into meetings and stuff without actually being hired. You know what I mean? But I think doing this kind of stuff is fine.
Yeah, definitely.
All right, listen, I'll leave you to it because you clearly, you're a busy man.
No, at this point, my busy is. I am just, I'm, I'm busy right now, and by busy I mean I have been stretched way too thin today.
Yeah.
And I'm at the point where I think it might just be a short day for me because it's just.
You just go do like just patrol for a bit, you know.
I've been though. That's the problem. It's just issue is that the theme of my time on duty is I go to one call and then immediately get pulled into a room. You know what I mean? So.
What's Barrick's, has Barrick mentioned his plans about anything yet? Any changes he wants to make?
Yeah, he's going to clean slate he's clean slating the hiring process, and we're going to start over because we've had so many applicants, but we are now going through sort of a different process so that we can try and keep a little bit more informed. Because when we first started, the process was a very fucking janky. It wasn't a good system. So hopefully now that we're more established, Barrick has a better idea for the hiring process. So
it's pretty good. Pretty good show.
Yeah. Got that. He's doing good. He's making strides. I got him in touch. I got Pixie in touch with him so that they can work in getting SOPs for 5150s and stuff for Crusade Medical and licensed therapists. I'm working on getting I'm missing something crucial. Oh, work on getting FTO set up. I am currently in the process of getting ready to interview 30 applicants.
Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm. I've gotten Chastity, the receptionist. You've met Chastity, right?
Yeah, I spoke to her about some improvements she's looking forward to. Obviously, she's ship 3. So.
She's incredible. She's awesome.
Yeah, she's great. Right. I got a question for you. Do you know, remember back in the day at our MDT, you could have like, there was an option to open the MDT in like dispatch mode and there'd be like a big map. You never really use it.
Yes.
Do we have that?
I'll tell you what, actually. Let me open up my MDT and I'll show you what it looks like.
Is on here. I wonder what all this shit is. Which one's the main desk?
I mean, if you look up on the monitor, you should be able to see sort of what I'm talking about. That's sort of what it looks like.
Oh shit. Okay. That's fucking nice. Clean. Oh, it's pretty nice.
It is. Yeah, no, it's very nice. That's our much more intuitive dispatch system. We still have a quick check for dispatch without the map, but
units on the map though. You can't see units.
Oh, let me take a look.
You can't see where anybody is.
It looks like that might be the case.
Hmm.
Let me play around with this. Hold on.
We haven't played around with this yet.
I really haven't looked.
I've been caught for like 3 months here.
Yeah, it doesn't. Which I don't know why. I kind of wish.
Yeah,
that's
what I mean. It's like if I get hired, the first couple of days, you're just gonna be like, okay, let's have a look at what we got. What needs changing? You know, what do we need?
I know you can put like pins down for stuff, but you can't see units or actually calls that are coming in. Now that I'm looking,
there's no. It's fine. It's gonna be a fresh slate. New chief of police, new dispatch. I want this room to be, filled. All the chairs to be filled eventually. So nice. Oh, what about if we could have a tow radio? We could have one of the dispatchers doing tow. Like a tow dispatcher.